Hey, everybody, it's your girl Queen Chill Mode coming at you with the 2018 second round preview prediction video of the Golden State Warriors and the New Orleans Pelicans. In this video, I'll attempt to answer some questions that could very well be keys to the series. Questions such as, when will Steph Curry return? Are the Pelicans for real? Who's going to guard Anthony Davis? Shoot, who's going to guard KD? I'll attempt to answer these questions and more on my way to predicting the winner of this series. But before we get into that, let's take a look back and see how these teams got here. New Orleans completed a 4-0 sweep of the Portland Trailblazers to everyone's surprise. Anthony Davis was outstanding. Jrue Holiday looked like an MVP candidate. And Nico shot lights out. Shoots. Meanwhile, Rondo turned back the clock, the hands of time, and went back to a time machine to have an outstanding performance throughout the series on both offense and defensive end. Meanwhile, the Golden State Warriors completed a gentleman's sweep of 4-1 over the San Antonio Spurs as Kevin Durant was dominant. Woo! Klay Thompson was on fire, and Draymond Green was doing Draymond things like anchoring their defense and dropping dimes, as if he's auditioning for a State Farm commercial with Chris Paul or something. Well, here are some questions that are yet to be answered, that will be answered as we move forward in these series. Like, when will Steph Curry return? He's already been scratched from game one, so we have no idea when he officially will return in this series, but at some point expect him to. And when he does return, he's expected to hit the ground running as if he hasn't been out for the last 2 months. He'll more than likely be guarded primarily by Jrue Holiday and Rajon Rondo whenever he does return. The key to this matchup will be, will Steph return slow? And if so, will he be able to gain separation while being guarded by two of the better perimeter defenders in the league in Jrue Holiday and Rajon Rondo? Or will he return as if he never left, shooting the shots that he shoots, dribbling, doing all the things that he does and we love that makes the Golden State Warriors offense go? That remains to be seen, but it's a matchup that I'm definitely looking forward to seeing. Meanwhile, are the Pelicans for real? I mean, they look phenomenal against the Blazers. Rajon Rondo averaged 11 points, 13 assists on 42% from three-point range, y'all. All the while playing solid defense and being engaged on the offense. Man, I tell you, if the NBA handed out first-round awards, Jrue Holiday would have been an MVP candidate. This dude averaged 27 points, 6 assists, and 4 rebounds, all the while smothering Damian Lillard and CJ McCollum like he was smothering pork chops in the kitchen or something. He looked fantastic. And one of the keys that I felt would be the series to that matchup with Portland was Nico Meritage, and he delivered. Averaged 18 points, 9 rebounds on 57% from the field and 43% from three-point range. Turned out to be the perfect complement to Anthony Davis in this series against Portland. Anthony Davis, on the other hand, was doing what Anthony Davis has been doing all season long, and that's dominating the game. He continued his MVP caliber season, averaging 33 points on 11 rebounds, 2 blocks, while shooting 57% from the field. Can Anthony Davis remain dominant? Would Jrue Holiday and Rajon Rondo win the battle against arguably one of the better backcourts in the league, and Steph Curry and Klay Thompson? Those things remain to be seen. But if they can, this series is going to get very interesting. Another key to this series is, who's going to guard Anthony Davis? I mean, Draymond Green is a perennial Defensive Player of the Year candidate each year. He has excellent strength. He's very active on the defensive end and may be able to move Anthony Davis off his spots. But that may not be as easy as it once was. Keep in mind, Anthony Davis is 6'10 with great leaping ability and is long, and Draymond is 6'7. Can we actually expect him to guard Anthony Davis by himself? Well, y'all know the saying, teamwork makes the dream work. Make it a group effort. I mean, the Warriors can opt to double-team Davis by leaving a non-shooter. Although Rondo shot 42% from three-point range in the last series, he's not known to be a consistent three-point shooter. The Golden State Warriors may very well take their chances on leaving a non-shooter to double off and to help out with Anthony Davis instead of allowing Anthony Davis to kill him. Also, Kevon Looney had a great series against the Spurs. I mean, he has great quickness, size, and instincts. He, too, is an option to guard Anthony Davis. You might ask yourself, why not JaVale McGee? I mean, he has length, he's athletic, but he can also sometimes be a liability on team defense. But the matchup that I'm hoping the Golden State goes to at some point in this series, Kevin Durant versus Anthony Davis. He's got the length, great ability to recover, and he'll still be able to contest Anthony Davis' shots. And keep in mind, his defense has definitely improved a great deal since becoming a Golden State Warrior. Definitely a matchup I'm hoping happens, and I hope it's a good one when it does. Another question, while we're asking who's going to guard AD, who's going to guard KD? I mean, my goodness. In the words of Alvin Gentry, everybody. You know, New Orleans is at their best when they go when they have a three-guard lineup, when they have Etuan Moore, Jrue Holiday, Rajon Rondo. I mean, all of those guys are undersized, and Kevin Durant will be able to see over all those guys. So, I mean, if he does decide to go with one of those three guys, primarily guarding Anthony Davis, it could very well be a long series for the New Orleans Pelicans. He may also opt to go with a bigger reserve. I mean, players like Solomon Hill, Darius Miller, and Cheick Diallo, you know, just to throw KD off maybe, give him a change of pace, give him some different looks, just to see if it may very well work. I mean, you never know until you try. But just like I'm looking forward to seeing KD guard AD, I'm definitely looking forward to seeing AD guard KD. KD will have an advantage with his quickness, his ball handling skills, and he does have a high release to kind of get his shot off against Anthony Davis. But I'm definitely looking forward to seeing who's going to win that battle. And whoever wins that battle could very well determine who wins the series. So, without further ado, who wins the series? I'm taking Golden State in six. Well, that's my time for today, folks. Thanks again for taking the time to check out your girl's channel. If you're not already a subscriber, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button and please like. Good night, y'all, and God bless.